what is going on, everybody? My name is Payne, and welcome back to another Studio Ghibli review video, and in my opinion, the final Studio Ghibli film in a long line of films that people just overlooked or forgot or don't really talk about that much, starting with Only Yesterday back in 1991, and now we're on to the final film here, which came out in 1995, a span of 5 films in 5 years. Because the next Studio Ghibli review after this one is a very, very, very huge one. And that anyone who knows anything about anime knows what this film is. So this is, in my opinion, the final film that, you know, people just didn't give that much attention to, really. And that's one of the reasons why I like making the series, is because with every video that's around 10 minutes, I'm giving each film the attention that it deserves, including this one. So now let's just get right into it. This is the one and the only Whisper of the Heart. Whisper of the Heart is a romantic coming-of-age drama anime film that was directed by Yoshifumi Kondo in his directorial debut, was produced by Toshio Suzuki, and was written by Hayao Miyazaki. It was made by Studio Ghibli, and it came out in Japan on July 15th, 1995, was released as a dub on March 7th, 2006. The Blu-ray was released in May of 2012, and GKids reissued it back last year, and it's 111 minutes long, or 1 hour and 51 minutes long. Alright, so I'm going to say the plot to the story. I normally don't do this for Studio Ghibli reviews at all, but I just found out of something that's coming up, and that is going to be the reason why I'm going to say spoiler warning right here, and the reason why I'm saying that will be at the end of the video, so make sure you stick around for that. Now let's go to the story of Whisper of the Heart. Once again, spoilers, you have been warned. So, Whisper of the Heart follows a 14-year-old girl named Shizuku, who's a huge bookworm and longs to be a writer when she grows up. One day, when trying to check out her favorite book, she finds out they were all checked out by a boy named Seiji. She later meets a boy who is later revealed to be Seiji, the same kid who checked out all the books she wanted, who does nothing but annoys her for the next few days, chronologically in the movie. And after deciding to follow a stray cat that was on her train, Shizuku stumbles upon an antique shop and sees a mini cat statue known as the Baron. When she walks down a set of stairs in the antique store to a workshop, she sees Seiji, the same kid that's been annoying her, working on a violin. After asking him to pull out one of the violins he finished working on, she asks him to play, but he says that he will only do so if she sings. And after tuning the violin up, easily in my opinion, the best scene of the movie begins as he starts playing in the melody to Country Roads by John Denver, and Shizuku starts to sing the new lyrics that she has written for her graduation. And about midway through the performance, the shop's owner and a couple of his friends stop by. They hear the music and decide to play along with them. It is a very sweet scene, and in my opinion, my absolute favorite scene in the entire movie. Shizuku then later befriends Seiji after he tells her that he is related to the shop owner, whose name is Shiro Nishi, and that he's been trying to make violins in order to become a master luthier, which, for people who don't know, it is someone who fixes string instruments such as a violin or a guitar. So while Seiji leaves to work on his passion for a couple of months, Shizuku decided to take writing seriously for that same time period, for the next couple of months, with the help of Nishi, the shop owner, who gives her permission to use the Baron, the cat statue, as a part of her story, if he is the first one to read it when it's done. And so during these 2 months, she stays up until the early hours of the morning. During that time, her grades also drop as well while she's making the story, but when she finishes it and then shows it to Nishi, her feelings of stress and frustration turns into feelings of relief, as Nishi tells her how great the story was. He later tells her how he got the Baron in the first place back when he was studying in Germany with his first love, Louise. It started when they saw two cat statues in a cafe and decided to buy them separately, as they both had to separate for a time, planning to have the statues reunite in the future. But unfortunately, due to Germany's rise in World War II, they never did. So in the end, Shizuku decides that she will continue with her studies to become a writer, and on the next morning, after she shows the story to Nishi, she sees Seiji, who had returned a day early so that he could finish high school before he becomes a luthier, and the movie ends with Seiji confessing his love to Shizuku. Whisper of the Heart, the movie, is based off of a manga of the same name by Aoi Hiragi back in 1989, and around that same time as the movie was being released, she made a sequel which shows both Shizuku and Seiji 2 years later, And as far as the movie is concerned, there were multiple things that the movie did differently from the manga, such as that there were missing subplots and there were characters that got more or less screen time as the manga. But my favorite change was that in the manga, Seiji didn't make violins at all. And there was nothing about Seiji leaving his town, to go and be better at what he's working on. And this was because the writer, Hayao Miyazaki, he wanted to change the story where he wants to make the characters work really hard to realize what their passion is. Yeah, he decided that, you know, he wanted to write both Shizuku and Seiji in a situation where, you know, they're both passionate about doing something, but they have to really work their ass off to do it. And makes them realize that, you know, this is their passion and that this is what they want to do. And Whisper of the Heart, the movie, was also a movie of firsts for Studio Ghibli. Such as this is the first time that they used digital composition, which helped with their animation, which means that the certain elements of some of the scenes were made using computer technology. Like, most of the only fantastical scene in the entire movie was made digitally, as well as also being the first film, not only for Studio Ghibli, but in Japan, to use the Dolby Digital sound system. Now, again, what this means is that the original animation was hand-drawn. It was still hand-drawn, but it was digitally comprised in the end. This was also the first movie with a theatrical release that wasn't directed by either Hayao Miyazaki, who, you know, instead was the writer of the movie, or Isao Takahata, who at the time was coming off of Pompoko, the review for that down below. And instead, it was directed by a guy named Yoshifumi Kondo, who was a longtime animation director for Studio Ghibli, and a longtime colleague of both Miyazaki and Takahata. And after the movie came out, all this stuff came out, you know, saying that he was expected to be the next Miyazaki, to be the next Takahata, to be the next creative successor for both directors. But unfortunately, on January 21st, 1998, while Studio Ghibli was coming off the success of Princess Mononoke, to which Kondo was the head animator for, he unfortunately died at the age of 47 due to an aneurysm that doctors said was brought on by overworking, and it was said that his death was the reason why Miyazaki initially retired for the first time before coming back to make Spirited Away a few years later. The final thing that I thought was interesting in terms of production for the movie is the translation to Country Roads by John Denver. Taking the Japanese translation, you know, putting that aside, it is a really good song, but the ending of the movie, where it has the initial Japanese translation, that got stuck in my head as much as the original American version did. There is someone singing the full English lyrics in the beginning of the movie. That was Olivia Newton-John of Grease fame. And that there were translated lyrics by Shizuku, known in the film by a different title. Instead of Country Roads, it's Concrete Roads. And that was written by Miyazaki. And the Japanese translation of the song at the end of the movie was originally supposed to be translated by Miyazaki, but he just straight up gave up on it. He didn't know what to do. So he gave it to a 19-year-old named Momiko Suzuki, who is the daughter of the producer, Toshio Suzuki, who helped translate it. But Miyazaki eventually did look over the lyrics before putting it into the movie. So one thing that Miyazaki is known for doing and has done a really good job in inserting into the story alongside Kondo's directing is the validity of the child's psychology, where everything felt real. When you see the characters interact, when you see them react to something, when they get happy, when they get sad, there is some wholehearted truth to it. It's just the right amount of dramatic flair, and it prevents a character from having one emotion become their whole personality throughout the entire movie. This is something that Miyazaki has implemented in most of, if not all, of his films, and once again, he does a great job here. The animation, as usual, was amazing, as each of the characters had their own look to them, and the background art was flawless, and to no surprise now, it looked like the animators paid a lot of attention to the cat statue, the Baron, and everything related to him in this movie, which, again, it makes perfect sense, because the next time that Studio Ghibli would have a theatrical release that didn't have Takahata or Miyazaki would be a movie known as The Cat Returns, which is a spin-off to Whisper of the Heart that follows the Baron entirely. The music in Whisper of the Heart was all right overall, but while the background music in this movie did a really good job of setting the stage for everything that was about to happen in the film. If I'm going to be honest, if you were to ask anybody about the music in Whisper of the Heart, or just ask anybody about Whisper of the Heart in general, they're going to talk about Country Roads. They're going to talk about either the English version, 95% of the people are going to talk about the ending, the Japanese translation, because that's fucking catchy. And then they're going to talk about as well, if you watch the dub, about Concrete Roads as well, and how the, you know, the English lyrics are different. The characters, when they showed up in this movie, they brought a lot of weight with them. With each character coming into the picture with a different story to tell, and with the relatively slow pacing of the film, they were given enough time to explain why they were so passionate in a certain goal or a certain object. And the chemistry between Seiji and Shizuku was cute, overloaded, and most importantly, honest. Going back to what I said at the beginning of the review, when I found out more about this film, unfortunately this was another film that not that many people have either watched or have given enough credit to because of the very little amount of the fantastical elements that Miyazaki is known for. In fact, out of all of his films, this one had, to be honest, the least amount of fantastical elements in it. Or you can argue that there may be another one, but this is, in my opinion, this case, as again, there was only really one scene that fully relied on just, you know, letting his imagination go. And that was because he let the main character, Shizuku, let her imagination go. And that the movie focuses more attention on character development instead of the plot. Just like another Studio Ghibli film that I reviewed even before I even started this series, and that was My Neighbor Totoro. Now, obviously, My Neighbor Totoro had way more fantastical elements because it was implemented very well into the story, but this one, it was just crunched up into one scene, and that's it. So, again, fortunately, this was the last film in a series of films that I've talked about that flew under many people's radars most of the time. So after this, there'll be ones that everyone remembers, and that it was because of the reasons I said earlier that, you know, makes this some people's favorite Ghibli film. And for me, even though this isn't my number one all-time Studio Ghibli film, Whisper of the Heart is definitely up there for me because it follows the simple premise of someone who decides to work as hard as she could to pursue her passion. And in this case, she's working on being a writer while also meeting a guy who's also trying to work on his own passion, which, to me, makes this film very relatable, while the romantic elements and slow pacing add to it very well, making this film something that I'll never forget for as long as I live. If you want to see a film that focuses on a certain story and plot, this film doesn't necessarily have that. Or if you want to see something overall out of this world and Miyazaki-esque, this also isn't the right film as well. But what this film has instead is a very detailed picture of its characters, which is at times heartwarming, at other times heartbreaking, and at all times true. And with that, I'm going to give Whisper of the Heart a 9 out of 10. Alright, so before I end this video, for anyone who lives in the United States, especially that is watching us, I'm going to give you a reminder here. Only on July 1st and July 2nd, as a part of Studio Ghibli Fest 2019, Fathom Events and GKids will be premiering Whisper of the Heart in theaters. So if you can, I highly suggest that you guys go check this movie out. And considering this is the first time I'm talking about a Ghibli film and it's actually going to be out in theaters, this is something that I just absolutely did not want to miss on. I am not sponsored by GKids in any way. This is something that I honestly wanted to bring to you guys. If anyone wants to see Whisper of the Heart in person, in theaters, then this is your chance on July 1st and July 2nd in theaters across the nation, thanks to GKids. I'm going to put a link down below to where you can put in your zip code and see what theaters near you will be premiering Whisper of the Heart. So once again, if you can, I highly suggest you do. It's on July 1st and July 2nd. I know it's pretty early, but you know, the earlier the better. And this is also the reason why I said spoilers at the beginning of the video. So now I can go to the actual ending. Thank you guys for watching this Studio Ghibli review video. If you like this movie, if you like Studio Ghibli, hit the like button down below. If you want to see more reviews, if you want to see more Studio Ghibli review videos, if you want to see more videos in general, hit the subscribe button either on the screen, down on the channel, or down in the description down below. I also have a bunch of other videos that you can watch. If you want to see any videos that I made in the past, there are videos on the screen, down to my channel, and also a few linked in the description as well. And with that out of the way, my name is Payne, and I'll see you in the next video.